In 5 months, the coronavirus was declared a pandemic as it spread to 185 countries, including Nigeria.
The coronavirus is the biggest threat this country has faced.
Hard days that lie ahead.
A time of disruption.
And is wreaking havoc on the global economy.
There can be no half measures.
Both a health emergency and an economic crisis.
So now, Nigeria is dealing with the global pandemic and the Lassa fever outbreak, which has already killed over 100 people this year. This period is really testing the quality of healthcare in various countries, with many of the best systems in the world struggling to cope with the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, with a healthcare system that's ranked at 142 out of 195 countries, many Nigerians have expressed fears, doubts, and anger about how prepared the country is for a pandemic, especially when you compare current statistics with other countries. So what exactly is the state of the Nigerian healthcare system, and why is it that way? This is Nigeria's 2020 budget. Less than 5% of it was allocated to healthcare. Back in 2001, Nigeria was one of the African countries that pledged to increase the annual health budget to 15%. For 19 consecutive years, it has failed to meet this target. The closest it's ever done was 6% in 2012. That's not even halfway there. If you also look at just how much money African governments spend on healthcare out of their total spending, Nigeria ranks pretty low. But why does this matter? We need to first take a look at Nigeria's health profile. Nigeria has one of the lowest years in life expectancy in the entire world. It's also among the worst 5 globally in infant mortality rate, maternal mortality rate, and HIV infections. These figures show there's certainly room for improvement in the health sector. Now, the money allocated to healthcare is meant to cover a lot. Salaries, equipment, even ambulances. The list goes on and on. Yet, so many hospitals and clinics are understaffed, and they lack the medical equipment and surgical supplies they need. There have also been complaints about the lack of general infrastructure. This lean funding leaves the health sector constantly overwhelmed.
You get hospitals where, you know, to even see glove, ordinary glove, an ordinary face mask, it go hard.
Recently, one of my friends lost her elder sister because of delay response. There was no health center in that community, no ambulance services. If there were to be quick emergency response, lives would have been saved.
For this year, 7 billion naira was allocated to purchase health and medical equipment for the entire country. Meanwhile, 4 billion naira was set aside to fix office buildings for the state houses in Abuja alone. While underfunding healthcare is a challenge, handling the funds is another.
Every health facility has a budget. My organization went on a community outreach to a village in Oyo State. This facility was built through one of the funds from the MDG project and all of those things. But that health center is occupied by goods. If you say resources are not sufficient, then that means that the little one we have to maximize its use.
In 2017, the cable reported that the Astral Clinic, which is expected to treat the president, his family, and staff, did not have paracetamol or cotton wool, despite years of investment and budgetary allocations. Now, as Nigeria faces the coronavirus, its healthcare shortcomings have been thrown into the spotlight. There's not nearly enough ICU beds, ventilators, or protective gears for doctors. Nigeria's finance ministry even reached out to Elon Musk pleading for his help for more ventilators. This tweet has since been deleted.
There's so many things that are very basic and are in short supply. The only reason people are so aware about ventilators is because there's been this issue with COVID. But in a primary healthcare center, for example, we should be able to have nebulizers and defibrillators. But there's so many things at the grassroots that we need so that people can access care in their communities instead of always feeding into the general hospitals, the tertiary hospitals.
In March, as the coronavirus cases in Nigeria were rising, doctors in Abuja, the nation's capital, were going on strike. The reason? Well, according to several reports, they hadn't been paid salaries for 2 months. We'll come back to this, but first, let's take a look at the statistics. The NMA says that Nigeria has about 40,000 doctors. With an estimated population of 200 million, That's one doctor to 5,000 Nigerians. Despite this personnel shortage, a huge chunk of doctors leave the country every year to practice abroad. A national polling agency says that more than half of registered doctors have since left Nigeria. In the UK alone, it is estimated that 12 doctors from Nigeria are registered every week, with more than 5,000 Nigerian doctors already working there. So why exactly are so many doctors leaving?
In addition to not providing equipment needed to work, they're not even catering for their welfare, and they hardly earn enough for their basic needs and for their families. So once a doctor sees an opportunity or a nurse sees an opportunity, they're just going to take the required exams and move.
Which brings us back to the doctor strikes. There's been multiple over the years. A lot of the same issues on repeat. Here's the average annual starting salary of a doctor in Nigeria. Compare it to their counterparts in the UK, or to the earnings of a Nigerian senator. There's also the issue of health workers' hazard allowance.
It's ridiculous to have a hazard allowance of 5,000 naira, and this is an issue that has come up several times.
The health minister was recently asked about it.
Are they being paid a hazard allowance for the job that they are doing? I am not aware of it.
Until April 2020, health workers' hazard allowance in public hospitals was 5,000 naira. Given all these factors, it's not a surprise then that 88% would consider relocating to work elsewhere. In April, the government announced a special COVID-19 allowance that was to last for 3 months. Doctors are not the only ones leaving the country. Tens of thousands of Nigerians leave the country every year to seek medical treatment abroad. The reason is obvious: absence of proper facilities and treatments. President Buhari complained about Nigeria losing over 400 billion naira annually to medical tourism, an amount that's bigger than Nigeria's budget to healthcare in 2019. Meanwhile, the president has drawn sharp criticism for traveling abroad for medical treatments after promising to end medical tourism in 2015. He has officially spent 179 days outside Nigeria for medical treatment since he assumed office. The ordinary Nigerian is left to endure the consequences of the poorly serviced health system. They have to pay a huge portion of their health costs before they can receive treatment. For every amount spent on health treatment, most of it comes from the patients. In this aspect, Nigerian patients spend more. To reduce the burden, the National Health Insurance Scheme, NHIS, was established. But it only covers less than 5% of the population.
Right now, the model of the health insurance we are operating on cannot work. It can't cover Nigerians because most of our economy is largely based on the informal sector. So any health insurance scheme that is able to provide a tailor-made solution for those in the informal market, that will be the best solution.
282 million was allocated to it in this year's budget. That's less than 2 naira per person. With more than half of the population living in extreme poverty on less than 800 naira a day, a lot of Nigerians can't afford proper health care.
The cost of care is a big challenge. Because even in the public hospitals these days, you have to pay. It looks token, but it's a lot for the majority of our people if we consider the poverty level.
Over 50,000 Nigerians die from cancer yearly, and almost 24% of all global malaria deaths happen in Nigeria. There still remains a lot to be done to strengthen the country's healthcare system.
Health is, I think, the number one priority in development. It's important that the government partners with private sector to invest in infrastructure specifically for healthcare. For instance, power, water supply.
So you can't improve the Nigerian health system without tackling the issues surrounding access or availability of facilities, the quality of care, and a patient's ability to afford that care.
There is the need for constant monitoring and evaluation. Most of the senior officers at the top, at the Ministry of Health, don't know what is going on at the grassroots.
In an emergency situation, it's essential that we look at what is the quickest way to achieve certain things and minimize the bottlenecks and also allow for creative response.
Beyond the pandemic, Nigeria has a very long way to go.